No matter where you are or what you are doing, things are changing all around you. Whether it's plants growing or logs burning, or even if you're just eating food, the materials around you are changing in size, shape, and structure, releasing or absorbing energy, and creating new substances. In chemistry, most changes are divided into two categories: physical changes and chemical changes. A physical change is something that changes the physical properties of an object or substance, like size, shape, or form. Cutting a piece of cloth is an example of a physical change. Even though the cloth changes shape and size when it is cut, it does not create a new substance. It's still cloth. Even if the pieces of cloth are sewn together and made into a shirt, only physical changes have occurred. The shirt is still made of the same substance as the original cloth, just in a new form. Another type of physical change involves changing states of matter, and water is a great example of this. Ice melts and becomes water, and water evaporates to become steam. But no matter its form, the water is still water. One way we can tell this is a physical change is that the change can be undone. Water vapor can condense back into liquid water, and liquid water can be frozen back into ice without changing to a different substance. In fact, many physical changes can be undone. For example, we know that dissolving sugar into water is a physical change, because even though the sugar and the water are mixed together, they do not combine and create a new substance. They are still just sugar and water, and they can be separated from each other. Not all mixtures are as simple to separate as sugar and water. When you mix butter, sugar, flour, and eggs, there is not a practical way to separate them again. But it is still only a physical change. The chemical change occurs when you put your mixture in the oven and add heat. Baking has many of the indications of a chemical change. The mixture in the oven absorbs heat. It also changes color and produces an odor. Gases are released, which is what helps the baked goods to rise. Finally, this change cannot be undone. You can't unbake a cake. Chemical changes occur when the particles of two or more substances are rearranged to form a new substance. For example, when you burn wood, the wood is transformed into a new substance, ash. Just like in baking, this change cannot be undone. Also like the cookies, the wood changes color, releases gases, smoke, and produces an odor. Unlike in baking, this chemical change releases heat and gives off light. Chemical changes take place all around us. Metal rusting, fireworks exploding, fruit ripening, and digesting food are all examples of chemical changes. Here are some clues to look at if you're not sure whether something is a chemical or physical change. Chemical changes always form a new substance. They may absorb or release heat. Sometimes a chemical change will cause a change in color, produce an odor, create a sound, release gases, or produce light. Chemical changes usually cannot be undone. Physical changes do not form a new substance. A physical change may change the shape or size of an object. It may change the state of a substance's matter. Many physical changes can be undone in some way. In a physical change, you end up with the same substance you started with, even if it looks different. I hope you enjoyed learning about physical and chemical changes today. Look around and see if you can identify the physical and chemical changes around you. Goodbye till next time.